morning, students. Welcome back to your English class. Students, in this class, we are going to continue with the present tense, as we have already done with present simple tense and present continuous tense. So, in this class, we will be learning present perfect tense and present perfect continuous tense. Okay? So, now, let's get started with the present perfect tense. Student, when we use present perfect tense, when we are talking about an action which has already done, in the present time before any other action. Clear? जैसे कोई भी verb आपने just किया, I have done my work. So this is also a present perfect tense. Okay. So now let's learn the structure of present perfect tense. Let's learn how to form present perfect tense. Okay. Let's get started. First you need a subject, then you need helping verb, and helping verbs are have or and then you will need a verb's third form. Okay. Now, object. Clear? So this is how you can form present perfect tense. Now the question is, where to use has and where to use have. Okay. So if you want to use has, you will use with the singular subject and have with the plural subject. Remember, with I you will always use have. Clear? Now, moving to the next is the example of present perfect tense. Okay, so the example is she or he has, because he is a singular subject, so you will add has along with it, and then he has written. He has written a letter. Right? So he is the subject here. Has is the helping verb and written is the main verb and it's a third form, and then our object that is a letter. Okay, now if you want to change it into interrogative, if you want to make a question with the present perfect tense, then first of all you need to change has, means you have to place the has in the place of subject and subject in the place of helping verb. Clearly? Clear? So, has he written a letter? So, remaining part hai wo as it is aa jayega. So, I think it's not very tough, right? So, now, to form negative. Negative form karne ke liye, what you have to do? You have to just place not after helping verb. What is the helping verb in the sentence? Has or have. Clear? So in the sentence has is the helping verb, you will add not along with it. So he has not written a letter. So this is a negative sentence. Okay, so first this is affirmative and this is interrogative, this is negative. Now what we are going to do, we are going to form interrogative negative sentence. Okay, so how to form interrogative? First you need a helping verb, right? Has he not written a letter? Okay, so this is interrogative negative. Now two parts are still remaining. The first one is WH word. Interrogative with the WH word. Okay. So, what has she written? So, we have not added a letter because we are asking what. Okay. So, what has she written? I'm going to read about present perfect continuous tense. Now, student, the question is, where to use present perfect continuous tense? Present perfect continuous tense. Okay, so present perfect continuous tense is the tense we use to show that action has already started in the past but still continue in the present time. Okay, so we can say, for example, I have been teaching tenses since Monday. Okay, so 2010. Okay, so she has been teaching English since 2010. So has been teaching. This is the main structure. Okay, now to change it into interrogative, you need has she been teaching English since 2010. And similarly, if you want to change it into negative, then you need she has not been teaching English since 2010. Next is, if you want to change it into interrogative negative, okay, then you need has she not been teaching since 2010. Okay, don't forget to insert the question mark. Okay, now we have learned it, done it, four kinds of sentence. Now it's turn of WH word questions or interrogative sentences. Okay, so now let's get started. What has she been teaching since 2010? What has she been teaching since 2010?
So students, this is all for today's class.